Well, when we go to our mother Khadija, أم المؤمنين رضي الله تعالى عنها وأرضاها, وخديجة رضي الله عنها, your mother, that you ought to mention more and more. And oftentimes we forget our mother Khadija. We remember our other mothers رضي الله عنهن أجمعين. May Allah be pleased with all of them and gather us with them in Jannah. We are their children at the end. لكن أم المؤمنين خديجة المجاهدة العابدة الزاهدة الكريمة, the generous, the house of the Rasul and the رسالة. هو السيدة خديجة كانت بيت الرسالة وبيت الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم. Both she housed the رسالة and her house. Sufficient honor that Allah Azza wa Jal chooses to reveal the رسالة الخاتمة, the final message, in the house of أم المؤمنين خديجة. البخاري narrates in his صحيح, جبريل عليه الصلاة والسلام comes and he takes permission before خديجة رضي الله عنها enters the house out of أدب with خديجة. He says to him, يا رسول الله السلام يقرئك السلام. Allah sends his salam to you and sends that special salam to خديجة, and he promises her that the akhirah will be much easier for her. The struggle that she's been doing is already seen. تمام. خديجة أم المؤمنين, الحديث روته أم المؤمنين عائشة في صحيح البخاري, باب بدء الوحي, the first حديث. When the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم comes home and he tells our mother Khadija about the رسالة, what does she tell him? She says the statement, and I think we all should know what the statement tells me is this half of the ummah, 50% of the ummah, Khadija Umm al-Mu'minin was 50% at that time. The ummah was two people, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم وأم المؤمنين خديجة الكبرى رضي الله تعالى عنها وأرضاها. And she, السيدة خديجة, out of all of the honorable wives of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, she lived with him the longest. يعني the longest of any of our mothers was خديجة رضي الله عنها. So guess what? She knows him the most. And she struggled with him when, like I said, in Mecca, because Sayyidah Khadija eventually passed on towards the end of the Meccan phase, right before the finish of Mecca, right before Hijrah, year before Hijrah, maybe even less. That's when she passed on. So she lived through the Meccan phase day by day, night by night, where An-Nabiyu al-Akram sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam goes from his home into the valleys of Mecca, calling the mushrikeen and the people who do dhulm and evil, Ya ayyuha an-nas, qulu la ilaha illallah, tuflihu, say la ilaha illallah, you will succeed. Witness that there is no God but Allah. You will succeed, it will help you. And instead of them listening to him, they would throw their slanders at him, they would throw their curses at him, they would throw filth wal-iyadu billah at him, stones at him, thorns at him. He gives them love and they give him evil in return, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, to the point that his honorable feet oftentimes were bleeding, and they also caused a wound on his honorable forehead. You all know he returns back to the home and to the heart of Umm al-Mu'mineen Khadija al-Kubra radiyallahu anha, where she welcomes him in his home and she wipes his blood sallallahu alayhi wa sallam off, and she comforts him and she stands with him in the trenches. She was the comrade in arms, if you want to use that word, in this risala, and the reason today we're enjoying Islam, one of the reasons. But what I look at from the hadith of a Sayyidah Aisha radiallahu anha Umm al-Mu'mineen is what Sayyidah Khadija said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and pay attention to this. The hadith is long, لكن the words that matter most in it, almost these here in this respect. He tells her, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I am commissioned with the risala. She knows, she's a businesswoman. Khadija radiallahu anha was a billionaire in today's numbers, not a millionaire, a billionaire. Maybe Abu Bakr maybe was a millionaire. Uthman was a billionaire as well. Abdurrahman bin Auf was a millionaire maybe. Sa'd was a millionaire. Lakin Sayyidah Khadija was a billionaire in today's numbering. She knows, a businesswoman knows, when you're doing business for a long time, you know the market. And more than knowing the market, you know people. Because in the old days, it was all people. She knows what it meant for the Prophet ﷺ to call in the economically, politically stable society of Quraysh to call for a new religion. Whoa. She knows. She knows how cruel Quraysh can be. She knows what it takes to fight for the kursi, because they will perceive it as such. But Sayyidah Khadija told the Prophet ﷺ this. قالت كلا والله لا يخزيك الله أبدا. يا رسول الله, Allah will never let you down. I still cannot process it right. This is a woman who married the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. No doubt, she saw in him what others did not see. Huh? Al-Busiri said that in his Hamziya. Al-Busiri, the one who wrote the Burda, has another qasida called Al-Hamziya. He said that in his Hamziya. He said, وَرَأَتْهُ Khadija, and Khadija saw him. And she saw in him the alchemy of happiness that she was looking for. وَرَأَتْهُ Khadija, she saw him. But she didn't just see a human being detached from his haqiqa, the haqiqa of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the eyes of Khadija. She saw in him the alchemy of happiness. And indeed, Al-Busiri said, she realized if it's soon enough that her house became a house, a quarter for Jibreel to come. Tamam. Sayyidah Khadija tells him, but still, how can she still, despite all this, how can she tell him, coming to her with all this big news, Allah will never let you down? What kind of iman immediately was in her heart, or was in her heart? What kind of firm iman was in the heart of our mother? May Allah Ta'ala be pleased with her. Something different. I really cannot, I still don't understand entirely. I still have a hard time processing this reality. Hence, Al-Mustafa Al-A'zam sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to say, إِنِّي رُزِقْتُ حُبَّهَا, I was given the rizq of loving Khadija. You can say whatever you want. Love is rizq at the end of the day. Love is rizq. You either have it or you don't. If you don't have it, ask Allah for rizq. Not, your heart does not give. Ajiz does not give ajiz. Al-Qawi gives al-ajiz.